Today is the 10th day of the 7th month on our Maker's Restored calendar. This day falls on the 24th day of the 8th month on his servant Satan's calendar. There now remains one last 11-day journey before the self-existing one that inhabits eternity sends forth the great and the fearful day of his hot indignation. Yahweh my Elohim caused his second son of his Zechariah 4:14 holy anointing oil to remove the covering from his house one smooth stone ago for this day and to leave it uncovered. Since then he has shown that he is with his son who bears his name and that this is not a matter of a physical house that is on a physical parcel of soil, although he is also soon going to reestablish his house here on earth on a physical plane as well. Yahweh has clearly shown that a physical house is far secondary to his family name. His house is wherever he causes his dual sons of his holy anointing oil to dwell, even when his end-time son of Adam, his second son, has no place to lay his head. This being the case, the Most High has established that you are either standing with his second son of his holy anointing oil, or you are standing against your Maker and against his house, and you are his enemy. This is why his word tells us that the latter glory of his house is far superior to the former glory. He tells us this in relation to the 21st day of the 7th month, the day of the 13th lap that I will discuss in a bit. The event of him removing the covering from his house, his physical house, on his holy mountain last year for this day, and that which he has orchestrated to follow it, are soon going to result in him showing you the shame of your nakedness. He is going to show the scattered descendants of Israel that you are not under the covering of his only begotten son's shed blood like you think that you are. You're going to be shaken from your drunken stupor and learn that you are merely covered by the make-believe blood of your father Satan's make-believe images of Yahweh's only begotten son. These past 12 months of his house being uncovered are going to result in him recompensing your rebellion to him. The Almighty is going to pour out his hot displeasure upon those of you that profane his Sabbaths and defy his boundaries and have absolutely zero regard for his righteous judgments. He is going to make good on his promise to reward those of you who are stealing from him and submitting to his name falsely. He is going to bring an end to your following after your father Satan's idolatries. The Day of Covering is a special Sabbath day that the Elohim of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel ordained for his set-apart people to afflict our lives each year in hope of him turning the tables right side up and setting the captives free. He chose this special day as a day for his special people to petition him to set his greatness in place and to raise up his house with his restorations of all things here on earth. Reality is the Most High is getting ready to show the scattered descendants of Israel that he has sent you into the captivity of the lies of Christianity that he gave you over to believe into as a result of your rebellion to him. His word says so. Yahweh honored your rebellious, uncircumcised hearts in sending you into this captivity of Mystery Babylon. Each and every year's Day of Covering prior to this year was a foreshadow of this year's 50th year, Year of the Ram Horns Day of Covering. This is reality. You should have come to his house to stand with his anointed so that your debt that you had to him on account of your stealing from him would have been covered. Instead, you knew better than the Almighty El. At the end of the 11-day journey and the 40-day that followed it, in the second year of the first Exodus, our ancestors refused to trust and obey his voice that he had put upon his servant that he drew out from the waters of Egypt. They knew better than the Almighty El. At the end of the following 11-day journey that Yahweh has orchestrated with his second Exodus, an Exodus out from the captivity of the lies that he gave you over to believe into, that is also the end of a 40-day period that ends with these 11 days, you are going to be given the choice that he gave to them. You can either choose to trust his word and obey his voice that he has given upon the one that he has drawn out from the fouled up baptism waters of the captivity that he has turned into his living waters on my behalf. Or you can die in your rebellion to him, utterly naked before his faces, like Adam and Eve found out that they were utterly naked before his faces when they chose his death penalty. The two people that remain standing with his two sons of his Zechariah 4:14 anointing oil are joined together with his second son on today's special Sabbath in obeying Yahweh's voice in petitioning him to cause his desire to be done here on earth as it is in his dual heavens. Today's only Sabbath of its kind each year is the eighth day of covering that he has now accomplished on his restored calendar. The 11-day journey that flows out from today's day of affliction will bring forth Yahweh's third consecutive true eighth-day Sabbath of his Feast of Ingathering. The great and the fearful day of Yahweh will become known to the inhabitants of the world on this day. It will fall on September 5th on his servant Satan's calendar. Yahweh my Elohim is indeed getting ready to set his greatness in place. Today's special Sabbath assembly is the 211th restored silver trumpet assembly at his house. He caused his servant Noah to load the first of the animals onto the three tiers of the 300 cubit long boat on 211. 7 days into these 11 days is also a very big waypoint in this. It is the anniversary of the day that he marked his servant Noah. He marked his servant that they sent to you in a similitude of his servant Noah in a big way on this day last year. The four blasts of his silver trumpet that will call today's assembly represent the sixth lap around your stitches of a month. The last seven laps of the 13 laps that will bring forth the great and the fearful day of Yahweh will occur on the first 7 days of his third consecutive extended Feast of Temporary Dwellings. The seventh day of this feast, which will be the 13th lap, is the day that his only begotten Son stood up and cried aloud, saying, "If anyone thirsts, let him come unto me," referring to letting us come unto the word of Elohim, "and drink. As the scripture says, rivers of living waters will flow out from the belly of him that believes into me." This is referring to the Most High's waters of his statutes that he has turned into his Son's shed blood flowing out from the belly of the one that believes into his word at this time. Turn back, O house of Israel. Why die? Come out from your playing the whore to Yahweh so that you and your seed can live. Come and drink his living waters and give praise to the Holy One of Israel. Or else prepare to become a recipient of his hot indignation.